Power grids of Luzon and Visayas still on alert this Thursday as the sizzling heat continues to cause electricity demand to spike. Now, grid operators say the Luzon grid will be under red and yellow alert throughout the day, while the Visayas grid will be placed under yellow alert from 1 p.m. to 9 p.m. The NGCP expects the Luzon grid to be under yellow alert until tomorrow, while the Visayas power grid is seen to remain under a similar alert level until next week. With this, Philippine energy officials are doubling down on their call for the public to save energy.
Wala tayong nakikitang malaking pagbabago sa sitwasyon. On the household level, kung pagtutuloy, papatuloy natin yan. Pagsisipid, makakatulong rin yan. But really, in the long term, alam mo naman, kailangan talaga ng karagdagang supply. Maganda rin sana kung tingnan natin yung lokasyon, yung teknolohiya, saka yung klase ng supply na papasok.
Ang panawagan natin sa ating mga electricity consumer, kung maaari, makiisa at magtipid sa paggamit ng kuryente, hindi lang para tulong na rin para sa sarili natin, kundi para makatulong din na maibaba ang demand natin.
Power distributor Meralco, for its part, has implemented measures aimed at easing demand. Government agencies moving to conserve energy amid the fragile power supply in the country. President Marcos had earlier ordered all government agencies to lower their power consumption. The Energy Department says it saved over 2 million pesos last year from the Government Energy Management Program. The DOE adds government's electricity consumption fell 23% last year due to conservation efforts. But it says this might not be doable at the moment amid the extreme heat in the country.
Sa pangkalahatan, sumusunod naman ang ating mga kasamahan sa pamahalaan. Nung nakaraang taon, medyo may konting decrease yung ating performance. Kasi nung nakaraang taon, on the average, ang nakikita nating reduction na nai-implement nila, pumapalo siya closer to 23% nung kanilang average consumption. Pero ngayon nga, siguro dahil sa matindi rin iinit, bumaba ito ng konti na sa more than a little over 10%. Karamihan ng ating mga government agencies, ang major contribution nila talaga ay yung sinisigurado po nila na yung kanilang mga cooling systems, yung ating mga aircons, electric fans, malinis po ito, napaproperly maintained. At yung importante nga po, kagaya ng ating mensahe sa ating mga kababayan, huwag masyadong ibababa po yung thermostat. Ilagay lang po natin sa mga 24 degrees para hindi po ganung kalakas ang konsumo nito.
House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro also calling for clear-cut policies to address the alleged Chinese infiltration happening in the Philippines. Castro clarifies the Philippines is not against having Chinese nationals in the country, but she notes Manila's maritime row with Beijing complicates the matter.
We are worried about the influx of the students, especially in the ed sites in Cagayan. So parang new phenomenon yan. With our experience kasi sa Pogo, diba, na nagkaroon din na investigation yung Pogo, and we have found out na merong mga PLA na naka-infiltrate doon sa mga Pogo sites. Kaya we are worried na baka may mga ganitong plano ang China, especially the government of China, because we have this dispute in the West Philippine Sea.
Security analyst Chester Cabalza, meanwhile, notes aside from Cagayan, other areas like Subic are also seeing an influx of Chinese students.
Subic is fronting the West Philippine Sea also. So it's not only exclusive in Cagayan, but I think in some of the key strategic locations in Luzon, basically. They're not our enemies. We just have a strategic problem with them in the West Philippine Sea. We have to put that into context. But at the same time, they should be transparent also in their businesses with us.